Hey, come here. Get past that low ceiling sign, it gets a lot taller. Outside or negative 20 degrees outside, it will always stay 52 degrees in here. Has anyone gotten dripped on yet? If you haven't already, you probably will. We call these cave kisses that come from our stalactites. Now stalactites form from the groundwater and the rainwater seeping through, and then the minerals getting caught on the ceiling. If they don't get caught on the ceiling, they'll get caught on the bottom, and we call those stalagmites. Now, normally both of these would be a lot taller and would touch each other, and we would call that a column. But one of our previous owners decided that it would be a very smart idea to cut down all the stalagmites and all the stalactites and sold them upstairs for about 5 cents a piece. Now, what he didn't realize is that they are in fact rocks, not crops, and they do take 200 years to grow about half an inch to an inch. Now he did leave us some cave art, so right here we have our cave lion or basset hound. So there's the head, the body, and then the tail. And they're having a staring contest with our box turtle. Now if you have a good imagination, or maybe if you've stopped at the winery, you might be able to see Homer Simpson taking a nap.
Oh my gosh.
Now the next part of the tour, there is a little bit of a low ceiling, so back there is about 25 to 30 feet, and when I shine my flashlight up here, you can actually see how deep the water is. Why our water is so green is because one of our previous owners, the same one that cut down all the stalactites and all the stalagmites, decided that it would be a great idea to use this as a wishing well. And he didn't pay his tour guide, so their pay was the coins in the lake. And since they didn't want to grab the pennies, because this is about 40 degree water, they didn't want to grab the pennies, so they grabbed all the valuable coins. They left the pennies behind and eventually caused the pennies to oxidize, eventually giving it this greenish tint. And right by our alligator, sadly, he is not real, he is just a rock. But right by his tail, you can actually see one of the last remaining pennies in the cave. Now, during the Battle of Lake Erie, Oliver Hazard Perry and his men were drinking lake water, so they were getting sick and they were dying, so they needed to find a new source of drinking water. So they found the Shawnee tribe. The Shawnee tribe led them down here. They drank the water, they barreled it up, took it back to their ship. So they say that is the reason why we won the Battle of Lake Erie, and if they hadn't found the Shawnee tribe, then we would be a part of Canada today. So in the Victory Hotel, one of the largest hotels in the world for its time, decided to use this for their miracle spas, and that's the Victory Hotel. And in these miracle spas, they claim that if you sat in there long enough, it would get rid of all your sickness, your illness, and your disease. When in reality, it just got people more sick. And then in 1919, the hotel mysteriously burnt down. To this day, no one knows what happened or what caused the fire. But they do say that the fire was so big that you could see it from Detroit for about 3 to 4 days. Now the next part of the tour is optional. If you want to go back down to that little room, you can. But as you're going down, there is a giant rock. We call that Headache Rock because
probably should take a class.
They were rich, but Celestia is worthless. It's very dense in Morty Celestis, meaning of the sky. Slick a sky. You might notice we do have some green crystals. It's because the light allows algae to grow, and it's so soft and so brittle that unfortunately. There would originally be crystals at your feet. We did throw them out to give tours that took about 10 years in total. Would have been a plan on that. Stalactites.
This big.
One not too big, but too much. That's what I said, as soon as we get in the car, the heat's going on.
Now, okay, how much faster is the jet expressive?